गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, टुडे वी डिस्कस कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ लास्ट वीडियो, नाइट्रिक एसिड. व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ नाइट्रिक एसिड? HNO3 इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ नाइट्रिक एसिड. इट इज द वन ऑफ द ऑक्सो एसिड ऑफ नाइट्रोजन. ओके, लास्ट वीडियो we discussed preparation of nitric acid. Okay, nitric acid prepared by using Ostwald process. Okay, and sodium nitrate and sulfuric acid. We prepared nitric acid by using those methods. Okay, here I want to discuss structure and properties of nitric acid. Structure, it has planar structure. Okay, it has planar structure. Here a nitrogen. Okay, here double bond O, here O, H, OH, and here O, double bond O. Here double bond O, bond angle is, 130 degrees bond angle. Here nitrogen HNO3. Okay, here nitrogen, hydrogen, this bond angle is 102 degrees bond angle. And here oxygen hydrogen bond length is 140.1 picometers. Nitrogen single bond oxygen bond length is 121 picometers. And here nitrogen oxygen bond length is 96 picometers. This is the structure of nitric acid. Then in continuation we'll see the properties of nitric acid. Okay, according to the Arrhenius acid, nitric acid is acid. Why? It donates H plus ion when it dissolves in a aqueous solution. Here, okay, first one, nitric acid was dissolved in water, that means aqueous solution means water, and forms hydronium ion. Along with that, nitrate ion was formed. Due to the formation of the hydronium ion, it acts as a strong acid. It forms hydronium ion falsely, that's why it is considered as a strong acid. And it is a good oxidizing agent. Due to the presence of oxygen, it acts as a good oxidizing agent. Okay, it can oxidize so many metals except noble metals like platinum and gold. Nitric acid not affected the gold and platinum noble metals, but it affects copper, zinc and other metals and form the different oxidized products. Okay, in different conditions, nitric acid, we have two types of nitric acid, concentrated nitric acid and diluted nitric acid. Okay, here, metals reacts with dilute nitric acid forms, different oxidized product. Metal reacts with concentrated nitric acid and forms different oxidized products. We'll see here. Okay, I want to take copper. It reacts with dilute nitric acid. It forms cupric nitrate, nitric oxide along with the water. This is the important product. Okay, it forms cupric nitrate and nitric oxide. Here, nitric oxide was formed. When copper reacts with dilute nitric acid, forms nitric oxide as a product. When copper reacts with concentrate nitric acid, forms same cupric nitrate along with nitrogen dioxide. along with nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide is the nitrogen dioxide is the important product here. What is the difference between these two? When copper reacts with dilute nitric acid, forms here nitric oxide. Okay, when copper reacts with concentrated nitric acid, forms okay nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide. Okay, this is the difference between dilute and concentrate. Dilute nitric acid forms nitric oxide, and okay here concentrated nitric acid forms nitrogen dioxide. As the same reaction, we'll see okay about the zinc. You take the zinc, reacts with nitric acid. Here I am taking dilute nitric acid. Okay, here also I am taking one more. Zinc reacts with concentrated nitric acid. What happened? Same. Here also zinc nitrate was formed. Here also same zinc nitrate was formed. Here forms N2O nitrous oxide. N2O we called as nitrous oxide. Along with water. Here nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide, same, but here different product N2O and NO. What are the differences between? Okay, what are the differences between? Okay, reactivity of copper and zinc towards the dilute nitric acid. Okay, here copper reacts with dilute nitric acid, forms nitric oxide. Zinc reacts with dilute nitric acid and forms nitrous oxide. These are the differences. Okay, differences between okay reactivity of dilute nitric acid towards the copper and zinc metals. Okay, and it also oxidizes. Okay, here it also oxidizes. Okay, different elements. Different elements into compounds. It can oxidize iodine into iodic acid, iodine into iodic acid, carbon into carbon dioxide, phosphorus into phosphoric acid, sulfur into sulfuric acid. Okay, here I am taking iodine. Okay, here iodine, carbon, phosphorus and sulfur. These are the elements. Okay, all nitric acid. This nitric acid oxidizes into different product. Okay, here nitric acid, iodine, in the presence of nitric acid, iodine oxidizes into iodic acid, HiO3, along with the nitrogen dioxide. Carbon also oxidizes into carbon dioxide along with the nitrogen dioxide. Phosphorus also oxidizes into phosphoric acid, H3PO4. Sulfur also oxidizes into sulfuric acid along with the nitrogen dioxide. Okay, I didn't balance the equation. You can do the balance. You can do this one. Okay, iodine oxidizes into iodic acid. Carbon oxidizes into carbon dioxide. Phosphorus oxidizes into phosphoric acid. Sulfur oxidizes into sulfuric acid. These are also some of the oxidizing properties of nitric acid. And one of the nitrate ion test. How to identify the nitrate ion? Okay, nitrate ion in inorganic qualitative analysis. Nitrate ion identified by using Brown ring test. Okay, first I wanted to explain what is the Brown ring test. Okay, here you have to take the one test tube, add nitrate ion solution add nitrate ion solution. Step 1. Then second step, take freshly prepared, here we are using freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution. What happened? Already prepared. What happened if you use already prepared ferrous sulfate solution? Actually, ferrous sulfate easily undergoes oxidation, or ferrous sulfate easily undergoes oxidation in the presence of atmospheric oxygen and converts into ferric sulfate. Ferric sulfate never form the brown ring. Okay, so that's why we use here freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution. Then add ferrous sulfate solution to nitrate solution. Here ferrous sulfate acts as a reducing agent. It can reduce NO3 minus nitrate ion into nitric oxide. Here we are using ferrous sulfate solution. What is the meaning of ferrous sulfate solution? Ferrous sulfate, which can be dissolved in water. That means it has ferrous, here H2O taken 5 times and here plus 2. Okay, here we will get the ferrous complex. Ferrous sulfate solution means ferrous complex. Okay, this ferrous sulfate solution to be added into the this one. What happened here? NO3 minus converts into NO. That means it reacts with NO. And form Fe. FeH2O taken 5 times. NO and plus 2. Here we have the SO4 minus 2. This we called as ferrous nitroso sulfate. The common name of this one is ferrous nitroso sulfate. This ferrous nitroso sulfate is brown in color. This formed as ring in between ferrous sulfate solution and sulfuric acid. In the presence of sulfuric acid. What is the IUPAC name of this one? IUPAC name of this brown ring. Penta aqua. How many water molecules are there? 5. Penta aqua nitroso iron. Iron here 2 is there. Iron 2 is there. So iron 2. Here sulfate is there. Right, sulfate. Complex. And this is the IUPAC name of brown ring. Common name of brown ring is ferrous nitroso sulfate. Where the brown ring was formed? I wanted to explain this one. Take test tube, add nitric acid solution, nitrate solution, and then add the freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution to nitrate solution. Then shake, you will get the uniform layer. And add the sulfuric acid from the walls, drop by drop, very slowly. And we'll get the brown ring between this sulfuric acid and this solution. That brown ring name is ferrous nitroso sulfate. This brown color ring of ferrous nitroso sulfate. IUPAC name of this one, penta aqua nitroso. Here iron 2 sulfate complex. This is used for the identification of nitrate ions. And what are the uses of nitric acid? Nitric acid is used for the preparation of so many types of fertilizers. It is also used for the preparation of so many nitro compounds in organic chemistry. It is also used for the preparation of explosive ammonium nitrate. It is also one of the important inorganic reagent. Nitric acid is the one of the important inorganic reagent. This is about the simple discussion of the nitric acid. Simple discussion of the nitric acid. Okay, this is about the nitrogen. Okay, in 15th group we discussed. One is preparation of ammonia, properties, structure of ammonia, and nitrogen oxides, so many oxides we discussed. Okay, and here nitric acid. Okay, nitric acid finished. Then in continuation we'll see the phosphorus. Phosphorus always here present in P4 form. Nitrogen present in N2 form. Okay, datomicity of nitrogen is 2. Datomicity of phosphorus is 4. That means 4 atoms present in combined state. Okay, that's why datomicity of phosphorus is 4. Atomicity of nitrogen 2, atomicity of sulfur 8, atomicity of carbon is 1. Okay, like that. Atomicity means number of atoms combined state, we called as a atomicity. Okay, here I wanted to discuss one first important topic, phosphorus oxoacids. Already I gave the definition for the oxoacids. Okay, the acids which are produced from their oxides by the hydrolysis. We called as oxoacids. Phosphorus forms 7 types of oxoacids. In that way, we'll see first one. Hypophosphorus acid. Okay, the formula of this one is H3PO2. This is also called phosphonous acid. Okay, second one, phosphorus acid, H3PO3. This is called phosphonic acid. Third one, phosphorus acid, orthophosphoric acid. This is also called orthophosphoric acid. Okay, its formula is H3PO4. And metaphosphoric acid, this sometimes we called as polyphosphoric acid. This is also called polyphosphoric acid. H3PO3 taken n times. Okay, and here pyrophosphoric acid, hypopyrophosphorus acid is H4P2O5. Its formula, pyrophosphorus acid formula H4P2O6, pyrophosphoric acid formula H4P2O7. Okay, it forms 7 types of oxides. One is hypophosphorus acid, H3PO2, and H3PO3 is the phosphorus acid. Orthophosphoric acid, H3PO4, metaphosphoric acid, HPO3, this is also called as polyphosphoric acid, pyrophosphorus acid, H4P2O6, pyrophosphoric acid, H4P2O7, hypopyrophosphorus acid, H4P2O5. Okay, here we'll see the oxidation state of phosphorus in these oxides. Hindi is oxy acids. Okay, here oxygen oxidation state -2, -2 into 2, -4. Here +3 is there. The oxidation number of phosphorus here +1. Here +1. And here phosphorus acid here -6. Okay, here -6. Here +3. That means the oxidation state of phosphorus is +3. Okay, here orthophosphoric acid here -8. And here +3, the oxidation state of phosphorus here +5. HPO3, okay, here -6, here +1, phosphorus oxidation state is +5. H4P2O6, here +4, here -12, that means here +8, that means single phosphorus oxidation state is +4. And here pyrophosphoric acid, here -14, okay, here +4, and here, okay, +10. Single phosphorus oxidation state is +5. Okay, hypophosphorus acid, here -10, here +4, here +6, here +6 na, +6 means oxidation number of phosphorus here +3. These are the different oxidation states of, okay, different oxidation states of oxo acids, phosphorus in oxo acids. Okay, here in continuation we'll see the structure of these oxo acids. Okay, first we'll discuss about the structure and number of PO bonds, number of OH bonds, number of P double bond O bonds. We'll see in continuation. Okay, oxo acids. We have 7 types of oxo acids. First, I want to discuss about this hypophosphorus acid, H3PO2. Hypophosphorus acid. First, H3PO2, first oxo acid, H3PO2. What is the name of H3PO2? Hypophosphorus acid. The oxidation number of phosphorus here, +1. Okay, here, I will give the structure of, okay, H3PO2. And number of bonds. Okay, we'll see number of bonds are present like that. We'll see. Okay, structure. Phosphorus is the central atom. Double bond O compulsory. Every phosphorus should have the double bond O. And here PO2, H3PO2. Okay, here all are present in a tetrahedral manner. P4 always present in tetrahedral manner. Here also tetrahedral manner. Okay, here PO2 na, okay, here OH, and here also H3PO2, P, H, and double bond O. This is the structure of H3PO2 na, OH. Okay, this is the structure of H3PO2. H3PO2. 1, 2, 3. H3PO2. How many pH bonds are there here? 2 pH bonds and 1 POH bond and 1 P double bond O bond. Okay, 1 P double bond O bond. Okay, here we have the number of bonds like that in hypophosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid, H3PO3. H3PO3 we call as phosphorus acid. And see the structure of phosphorus acid. P double bond O compulsory. Okay, here OH compulsory. Here also OH. And here H. H3PO3. Here, how many pH bonds? 1 pH bond. Okay, 2 POH bonds. 2 POH bond, 1 P double bond O. 1 P double bond O bond. 1 P double bond O bond. Okay, this is the structure of H3PO3. And H3PO4, structure of H3PO4, phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid. Okay, P double bond O. Here OH. Okay, here OH. And here OH. And here OH. This is the H3PO4, This is the structure of phosphoric acid. It contains 3 POH bonds, 1 P double bond O bond. And here we'll discuss the basicity. Basicity of means, okay, number of H plus ions. Okay, number of H plus ion produced from the an acid we called as a basicity. Or capability of an acid reacts with the base. We called as a basicity. Here we have one OH. So here basicity is 1. Basicity of hypophosphorus acid is 1. Here 2 OH groups are there. So the basicity is 2. Okay, here 3 OH groups are there. So basicity of this one is 3. Only okay, H plus ion replaced from H OH only. So we mentioned like this. Okay, this is about the basicity of various acids. Okay, basicity of hypophosphorus acid is 1. That means it has capable to react only 1 mole of alkali. 1 mole of alkali, 1 mole of base. Or it donates only 1 H plus ion. Here, phosphorus acid donates only 2 H plus ions. Phosphoric acid donates 3 H plus ions. That's why we called as basicity of that one is, okay, 3. Next in continuation, we'll see. Okay, pyrophosphoric acid. Structure of pyrophosphoric acid. H4P2O7. This pyrophosphoric acid produced from the phosphoric acid. When phosphoric acid, okay, reacts with phosphorus pentoxide, dehydrating agent, and forms phosphoric acid, pyrophosphoric acid. H4P2O7. This is the formula of pyrophosphoric acid. Here, P double bond O. Okay, here O. Here, P double bond O. And here, okay, here H4 na, OH, here OH, here OH, OH, H4, 1, 2, 3, 4, P2, O7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, H4, P2, O7, here how many OH groups are there? Four OH groups means it is a tetrabasic acid. How many POH bonds are there? POH bonds are 4. P double bond O bonds are 2. And POP bond is 1. Bridged bond is there. Okay, that bridged bond. One POP bridged bond is there. Okay. Here it is a tetrabasic acid. And here H4P2O6. Pyrophosphorus acid means same. Here we don't have the POP bond. But here OH, here OH, here OH, here OH. This is the structure of pyrophosphorus acid. Pyrophosphorus acid also tetrabasic acid. It is also tetrabasic acid. Here it contains 2 P double bond O bonds, 4 POH bond, 1 PP bond. Here also 1 PP bond. It is also tetrabasic acid. Why? Here we have the 4 OH groups. That's why we called as tetrabasic acid. And here, okay, here H4P2O5. It is hypopyrophosphorus acid. Hypopyrophosphorus acid means P double bond O, OH, and here H, P, P double bond O, OH, and OH. How many are there? H4, 1, 2, 3, 4. P2, O5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the tribasic acid. Okay, it is a tribasic acid. It contain how many POH bonds? 1, 2, 3. POH bonds are 3. PP bond is 1. PH bond is 1. P double bond O bonds are 2. P double bond O bonds are 2. PH bond 1. POH bonds 3. So it is a tribasic acid. 1 PP bond is there. 1 PP bond is there. Okay, here this is the structure of pyrophosphoric acid. Pyrophosphorus acid, hypopyrophosphorus acid. These are the structures of these different oxo acids. And here, one more oxo acid is there. What is that? Metaphosphoric acid. Metaphosphoric acid, it is also called polyphosphoric acid. It contains number of HPO3 groups. All these HPO3 groups are arranged in two manners. One is cyclic manner and one more is in linear manner. If HPO3 groups are arranged in a linear manner, we called as polymetaphosphoric acid. If HPO3 groups are arranged in a cyclic manner, we called as cyclic metaphosphoric acid. Here I wanted to explain structure of metaphosphoric acid. This metaphosphoric acid exists in two ways. One is polymetaphosphoric acid, and second one is cyclic metaphosphoric acid. The formula of metaphosphoric acid is HPO3 taken n times. For cyclic means n is equal to, it may be 3, it may be 4 like that. But in poly means n is equal to number of. Here I wanted to write here polymetaphosphoric acid. Here P. Double bond O here. OH compulsory. Here O. Here extension will be there. Then O. Here O. Phosphorus. Here I am writing like this, phosphorus, double bond O, OH and O. Next O, and here P, double bond O, OH, O taken n times. This is the one HPO3 group. We mention like this. HPO3 group. This is one HPO3 group. This is one HPO3 group. Extension will be continuation. Extension to be continued like this. And here, this is the structure of polymetaphosphoric acid. Then we'll see the structure of cyclic metaphosphoric acid. Cyclic means HPO3 taken 3 times. 3 molecules formed like this. One, here oxygen, here P double bond O, oxygen, P double bond O, oxygen, like this. Here metaphosphoric acid means OH group will be there. Instead of like this, I mention like this, P double bond O, COOH. Here I will cross, just crossing the lines, OH. Here also same, OH. This is the one HPO3 part, this is the one HPO3 part, this is the one HPO3 part. By combining of 3 HPO3, we will get this trimetaphosphoric acid. In continuation we'll write tetrametaphosphoric acid also. This is the polymetaphosphoric acid. Polymetaphosphoric acid we called as linear. It is called cyclic. It is also called chain, long chain also. Sometimes we may call as long chain polymetaphosphoric acid. Here this is trimetaphosphoric, poly, linear, chain, long chain, all different names for the okay, this polymetaphosphoric acid, okay, cyclic metaphosphoric acid, it is a cyclic metaphosphoric acid, cyclic metaphosphoric acid contains three phosphoric acid molecules or three phosphoric acid molecules or four phosphoric acid molecule. This is about the discussion of phosphoric acids, okay, phosphorus acid and oxo acids of phosphorus. Then in continuation we'll see the allotropic forms of phosphorus and other. Okay, we'll see in continuation. Thank you.